Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm so happy to be here in the house of the Lord. There is fullness and joy. Hallelujah. God bless you all. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's open the Bible in Matthew 16, verse 19. Amen. Matthew chapter 16, verse 19. Thank you, Lord. Matthew chapter 16, verse 19. I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm so happy to be here. Hallelujah. I'm so excited when I am in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. It's so grateful. Amen. Praise the Lord. Tonight we're going to talk about the set keys. And the Spirit of the Lord led me in Matthew chapter 16, verse 19, where Jesus said, I give you the key of the kingdom of heaven. Thank you, Lord. The title is the powerful key. Jesus, the universal key. Why Jesus is the universal key? I remember when I was in high school, there was a man who was a guardian. He has a lot of key. He has a lot of key in his pocket. He was able to open every classroom, but he got some limitations. He couldn't have access with the administration. What we see, we can have many keys, but if we don't have the good one, we can't get in. But there is only one key with which we can open every door. The name is Jesus. Praise God. We should use the universal key, Jesus. Why should we use the universal key, Jesus? We couldn't ever enumerate all the reasons which makes us say Jesus is the universal key. There are too many. However, we can select at least two reasons across this sermon. First one, the name of Jesus gives salvation to every believer. Jesus died for the world according to John 3, verse 16. Let's read John 3, verse 16 together.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe on him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus dies for the world. Jesus died for you and me. That's why we are here today, by the grace of the Lord, by his love for me and you. Hallelujah. We are alive. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus gave all nations access to the kingdom of God. According to Acts chapter 4, verse 12.
Let's read together. Verse 12.
Amen, praise God. And in none other is there salvation, for neither is there any other name under heaven that is given among men, wherein we must be saved.
Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve.
Hallelujah. Jesus gives all nations access to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. That's why tonight, me and you, we have access in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. We can come before the altar asking him for his forgiveness, for his grace, because Jesus gives us, hallelujah, the access. We have the key. Hallelujah. To the kingdom of God. Praise God. Hallelujah. The second one, Jesus' name gives authority. According to Matthew chapter 16, verse 19, the name of Jesus, hallelujah, give authority. Amen. That's why he said, I gave you the key of the kingdom of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. We have the power. We have the key. Hallelujah. We can open, hallelujah, every doors. Hallelujah. By the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Jesus' name heals whatever sickness. According to Luke chapter 17, verse 11 through 14. Luke chapter 17, verse 11 through 14. Let's move on.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 17, verse 11 through 14.
Amen. And it came to pass, as they were on their way to Jerusalem, that he was passing along the borders of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, who stood afar off. And they lifted up their voice, saying, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, go and show yourself unto the priests. And it came to pass, as they went, they were clean. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Jesus' name heals whatever sickness. Hallelujah. What a mighty God. His name. Hallelujah. When we read Mark chapter 16, verse 17 to 20, we see Jesus said to the disciple, hi, hallelujah. He said, in my name, you shall cast out demons. Amen. And in my name, you will lay hand on the sick, and the sick will be healed. Hallelujah. So me and you tonight, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, we can cast out demons. In the name of Jesus, we can lay hand on the sick body, and the sick body should be healed. In the name of Jesus Christ, praise God. Jesus' name calms the storm. Hallelujah. Jesus' name calms the storm. Hallelujah. According to Matthew chapter 8, hallelujah, verse 23 through 27. Matthew,
hallelujah,
chapter 8.
Matthew chapter 8, verse 23. Praise God.
Through 27. Amen. And when he entered into a boat, his disciples followed him. And behold, there was a great tempest in the sea, insomuch that the boat was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. And they came to him and woke him, saying, save, Lord, we perish. And he said unto them, why are you fearful, O ye a little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. And the man marveling, saying, what manner of man is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him?
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus' name calms the storm. Hallelujah. Whatever the storm, whatever the circumstances, Jesus can calm it. Amen. Hallelujah. He rebuked the storm. He rebuked the sea. And they obey him. Praise God. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We have the power. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. As conclusion, we've just seen that Jesus is the universal key for the following sorrows. Jesus' name gives salvation to every believer. Jesus' name gives authority. My brother and sister, the same power is in us when we accept Jesus into our lives. According to Romans 8, verse 11. I want to tell you that we as Christians, greater is in us than the world. Jesus gives us the key of the kingdom of God. He gives us all the authority. Amen. We have more power than we think. According to Luke 10, verse 19, Jesus gives us all the power, the authority. Amen. Hallelujah. We should use and keep the universal key. To use your key. Hallelujah. We should use and keep the universal key, Jesus. The name of Jesus can unlock every door. Now, it's your time. It's your time to use your key. It's your time to use your key. You have the power. You have the authority. The name of Jesus. Jesus, he gives us the power. Now, it's your turn. It's our turn. It's our time now to use the key. To use the key in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God is good all the time. We give you praise, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for the key. Thank you for the key of the kingdom of heaven. We give you praise, Lord. Hallelujah. We give you praise. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Praise the Lord.